the 30 in, not 30 shift in. This is only taking and changing the number of payments for you.
Got it. I was looking at, yeah.
Okay. All right. So everybody good with that? Okay. Now, if we were using our calculator, we go back over here, we've got that number, 98,151,65. Now, make sure you're writing all this down, because you're going to do this by hand, or just like this, on the quiz. Okay? So you're going to take this, you're going to multiply it by 3%, okay, so 98,151,65 times 0.03 means that our prepayment penalty on this would be 29,44,55, okay, everybody cool with that? Yes, no, okay, now let's do the same thing over here. Now we could, of course, just right here to next to the number, simply say, okay, let's just take that number, multiply it by the 3%, and plug in the number. But we don't want to have to do that, okay? We want to actually use the value of what the spreadsheet has to offer. Let's go up here. Okay. We're going to type in payoff in month number. Okay. All right. So here I'm just going to type in 36. That's the month that we're going to pay it off. We could, if I want to be more precise, I could say payoff at end of month. More precise with the word. Okay? Everybody with me? Alright, so first things first. Let's go down here and we're going to do a little formula. First of all, we're going to calculate future value. Okay? That's what we haven't talked about. Okay? Future value is where we want to find. In this particular instance, we want to find what the value of something is going to be at some point in the future. Well, what are we wanting to find this in the future? The loan balance. Yes? Okay, so we're going to start out, and much like with the payment calculation over here, we've got some variables that you got to fill in. We've got to fill in the rate, number of periods, payment, present value type, potentially. So let's take a look. Okay, the rate is this 10%, just like we did before, C5, divided by 12, make it monthly, comma. Now, number of periods, this is where we're basically, this is now no longer talking about the number of periods in terms of the total loan term, in terms of the total loan term. Here, we're saying, what is the number of periods that we want to elapse before we calculate what that future value is going to be? So in this case, it's going to be 36 months, okay? Now, since it's already in months, we don't need to adjust it in terms of, you know, multiplying it by 12, because it's already in months. So what you can do is you just cell reference that cell, which is F4, okay? Hit comma. Now, the next one it asks you for is what is the payment? Okay, the monthly payment for the loan. Okay, so there we would be accessing this monthly payment over here. Now, what we may have to do in order to deal with what you were referring to earlier, the whole sort of inflow, outflow, pluses and minuses, and that sort of thing, we're probably going to have to make that payment a negative number. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the negative sign, go over here, grab that payment, comma, and then I'm going to go up for the present value, grab the loan amount, and then I'm going to close the parentheses. Let's just see if I'm correct. Yippee, I am, okay. So, it gave me the 98,151.65 as that, the balance. Now, what we can do is we can hit the negative sign in front of that to make that a positive number. Okay, so there are the actual cells. So, for this equal negative future value, open parentheses, C5 divided by 12, comma, F4, comma, negative, or the negative minus sign, C7, comma, C3, close parentheses. Okay? So all that is doing is that is giving us that balance of the loan at the end of, in this case, the 36th month. Now the cool part about this is that we can go up here and we can say, well, what is the loan balance after, I don't know, 12 months? Boom. There it is. Okay, make sense? So in one sense, it saves us from having to look down on that amortization schedule to see what the balance is. We should be able to type in 360, and it should be zero, because obviously that's the end of the payoff. Or month 180, still 81,000. Anyway, getting back, putting back to the 36. Okay, so we're not done yet, because we still have to take this number and do what? Multiply it by the prepayment penalty. Okay, so what we can do is we can simply take this whole argument here, put all of it in one big parentheses on both sides, and then multiply it all by the cell reference F3, and boom, there we are. So once again, I'll put it up there just in case you didn't see it. So all I did to modify it was I put a parentheses up here, right after the equal sign, put another one right here to enclose that whole argument, all in one, just to make sure nothing gets polluted, and then put the asterisk for the multiplication times F3 for the prepayment penalty, and then hit enter, and then that automatically tells us what that prepayment penalty fee will be if paid off at the end of that month. So I'm just going to go ahead and put over here. Okay. Everybody good with that? Yes, no, possibly good, babe.
Can you just open it again?
Okay. This and the numbers are going to change appropriately?
Right. Oh, because yes, because you can still input 3%. You can change it
3%. Okay, let me just do this. So, if, for example, just to test this out to make sure it's working on everybody's machines, let's change this prepayment penalty to 5% and change the payoff at the end of month 48. Okay? So, if you end up with 48, 70, 11, everything is good.
Still good.
Okay. Then that's fine. Okay. So far, so good. Yes? Okay. Let me put it back to what it was. Okay. Now, so at this point, all we have done is we've simply said, okay, we pay off this loan early, we paid off after 3 years, we've got to come out of pocket $29,44.55. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. What that doesn't tell us is, how does that really impact our effective cost of borrowing? Because in one sense, here's the way you've got to need to think about this. Okay, you're making that payment 3 years from now, yes?
Yes.
Okay, make sure you're following those logics. You lose on the logic, you're gonna be screwed. Okay? You're making this payment 3 years from now of this $29,44.55. So what we've got to do is we've got to say, in one sense, if we were really sort of like allocating that roughly $3,000 expenditure over the first 3 years, what would it really equate to in terms of our interest rate going up? Does that make sense? That's conceptually what we're trying to in essence do. Because we know that it's costing us, you know, our base interest rate is 10%, but because of this prepayment penalty being assessed 3 years from now, our effective cost of borrowing is going to be something greater than 10%. We don't know what just yet because we haven't done the calculation, but we know it's going to be something greater than 10%. Yes, sir.
So could you kind of look at it like when it would be worth it to pay it off, adding in the prepayment penalty?
Precisely. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. You thought we were done with this. We're not. Okay? So what we've got to do is we've got to basically say, all right, we know that this is occurring here, this 29, 44, 55. So in essence, here's what we probably need to do. Leave those numbers up there. All right. So once again, 12 payments per year. And we've gone and we've found this number, $98,151.65. And that is going to be. Now, think about this from the perspective of the borrower and the lender. This is going to be definitely one of those instances, Natasha, where it makes a difference, whether it's a negative or whether it's a positive. Okay? So, from the borrower's perspective, whenever we go to pay off this loan at the end of month 36, is that a negative or a positive to us?
Negative.
From the borrower. It's a negative. Okay? Now, to this number, we must add the 29, 44, 55 to the balance. Okay, I'm just gonna put the equal down here. So we find out what those two added together are. So that means that at the end of 3 years, we're actually going to be having to pay back the lender more than we originally borrowed. Okay? All right?
So would this be considered at this point negative
equity? Yeah, exactly. Or negative equity. Okay, now, we take this number, make this a negative future value. Okay. Now, how many periods have gone by?
36.
So we can either put in 36 in.
Do we need to clear all before we start doing that?
Yes, but figure out, that's why you have to have all of this.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, then we come up here, all right, so 36 in, or we could have put in 3 shift in, given that it is really 3 years. But in this case, we short case it, we just simply put in 36 in. All right? Now,
excuse me, what goes after the plus and minus?
Future value.
Okay.
Okay? All right? So, what is our monthly payment? Our monthly payment has been $877.57, and that is also a negative number as our payment amount. Okay? You see that we're kind of working backwards to in one sense. Alright? Everybody good so far? Yes? Okay? And we're about to get to the magic. Okay? So the next step is that we would then put in the original loan amount of the $100,000 as a positive present value. And you're saying, what do we have left to solve for?
Interest.
Interest rate, yes. This is where we find out what is the impact of this. So it should be something greater than 10%.
10.84.
Okay, so let me just do it myself real quick. The independent verification that I so desperately need sometimes. Okay. So if you put in everything correctly, you should get 10.84%. So now, what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story is that because of that prepayment penalty, our effective cost of borrowing on this particular loan went up from a stated interest rate of 10% to 10.84%. So almost a full percent just off of that prepayment penalty alone. Does that make sense? Yes or no? Yep.
Can we do the spreadsheet to calculate the percentage going up?
Absolutely.
Okay.
That's what we're about to do. Okay. But everybody understand that to that point? Yes? Okay. Okay. So here, we're going to call it effective cost of borrowing. Okay, we're going to use a function called rate, equal rate, okay? And we're going to see if we can plug in all of our variables and get to what it is that we are attempting to solve for here. All right? So here, we've got, first of all, our number of periods, which in this case is going to be the 36, comma, and then the payment, which was the negative 877.57, or cell C7, comma, the present value of the 100,000, comma, and here we actually need to reference sort of what we had done before. I can do this a couple of different ways. I may want to split this out just to make things simple. Let me do this. Okay. All right. Hold off on that just for a second. Let's do this. I'm going to make this simpler for you. Okay. So I'm going to move that effective cost of borrowing. Move the effective cost of borrowing down one line, and I'm going to put here balance at end of month payoff. The reason I'm doing this is so that I can capture that number from that we had up here. So what I did, and I just, in essence, you can just retype it again if you want to, or try to cut and paste that piece of it. But so for the balance at the end of the month payoff, just the equal negative future value, and then the cell reference of C5 divided by 12, comma F4, comma negative C7, comma C3. Okay, so that's just what we had done before.
Where did you get it from?
Right above the prepayment fee. Okay, so that's just giving us that balance. Okay, that makes this a lot easier here. Okay, so back to the equal rate. So the rate, number of periods, 36, comma, negative 877.57, comma, 100,000, comma, and then the future value here, we're gonna make that a negative number, so we're gonna hit negative, and then the 98,000, and we're gonna try to do it without a guess and see if it works. Okay, it's giving us 1%, hold on. Not a bad thing. We're going to kick that out about 4 decimal places. Now, it's giving us 0.8333, okay? Now, at first glance, you're going to say that's the wrong answer.
No, you got to add the 10.
No.
Plus, no.
No. Well, not well. Sort of. You're going to have to add that, but also there's one other piece. Okay, this is a monthly rate. We've got to make it annual. So the first thing we've got to do is multiply by 12, and you're going to get, and you should get 10. Yep. Okay. So that is the correct answer without putting in the prepayment penalty. Okay. So now what we've got to do, really simple, is we go back up here, and for our future value piece, this F6, we're going to take, and we're going to have to do what? Add in the 2944. Okay, so let's see. We may have to do, oops. Other way around, subtract it out. There we go. All right, so 10.841, does that match up? Yep. Okay, so let me pop it up there again so you can see it. And we move my thing over here a little bit. Okay. So let me walk you through it. Okay, equal rate, open parentheses, cell F4, which is the number of periods that have elapsed for the loan payoff period. Then we put in negative C7, which is referencing our monthly payment of $877.57, comma C3, which is simply our original loan amount of the $100,000, comma negative F6, which is, in this case, our balance at the end of the month payoff, minus F5, which is the $2,944.55. And the reason we have to obviously make that a negative is to revert, since the signs are reversed, in order to obviously add the two of them together, that's when we have to do that. Close parentheses.
What is the F5?
The F5 is the $2,944, is the prepayment penalty amount. And then multiply all that by 12, and we've got our answer.
Can I see the formula for the balance at EOM? At the end of the month?
Yeah, it's the same as the one right above it, with the exception of the multiplying it by the 0.03.
Why is the 98 number, 98151?
What is that number?
No. Why is that number negative?
Oh, because that's just simply, once again, from the computer perspective, just like on the calculator's perspective, it's looking at it as if the borrower is making the payment to the lender.
Oh, because that 98 would pay to the lender.
Correct.
Go back to one more time.
It's identical to the one right above it, with the exception of multiplying it by the 3%. Okay. All right. Now, so that is beautiful. That gets us one piece of the puzzle. We're not done. We still got at least two more pieces of the puzzle. We've got what? Loan origination fees to factor in. And we've also got the ongoing servicing fees or administrative fees to add in. So, yay! Okay? Now, all right, so let's just play with this just for a second, all right? Just to kind of make sure that, once again, all your calculations are correct. So let's just sort of go up here, starting with the prepayment penalty percentage. Let's change it to 5%. And the payoff occurring in, let's say, month 12. Okay? So all I did was change the prepayment penalty to 5% and making the payoff a lot sooner, making it at month 12 or at the end of the first year. Okay, so making those two adjustments to this, look at what that did to our cost of borrowing. Spiked it up dramatically. Okay, make sense? Because, once again, the logic here is, number one, this payoff has to be amortized over the time you hold the loan. And so if you're holding the loan a shorter period, then that's less time for it to be amortized over, meaning a higher overall cost. Okay? All right. Now just for fun, not that this is really overly realistic, but what if we didn't pay it off at the end of month one? Yikes. Okay? And you're saying, wow, 70%? Is that real? Yeah, it's real, because think about it. It really means you're making that first payment, and then you're cutting a check to the lender for almost $5,000, and then you're saying, bye-bye, and moving on. So your effective cost of borrowing is really, really high because it's such a short time period before you know, obviously are paying off the loan. Now, here's the reason I put that up there. There are an awful lot of people out there, especially on the residential side of things, that every time interest rates would drop just a tiny little amount, they would refinance. And in a lot of instances, that cost of refinancing was not free. Sometimes it is. Sometimes your lenders will say, okay, you know, we want your business and we'll let you refinance without any real substantive cost. But other times, there's usually still some cost associated with it. And if you're refinancing after only a couple of months or whatever it may be, it's like your real cost of financing could go up dramatically. Now, granted, your cost savings could be substantial, too, if you hold that new loan for a long period of time and really are able to recapture those savings. But you have to be really careful about that. Okay. Everybody cool?
Can you put the cursor on the effective cost of borrowing? I'm not getting the right answer.
I'm not getting the formula. Effective cost of borrowing.
Okay, you're not getting that.
I'm not, no.
Okay. First, let's just start with...
Let me
pop it up. The one piece that you may be messing up on is make sure that you've got F6 is a negative and then minus F5.
I'm getting it now. I was missing the 12, but for some reason I didn't get the I'm getting the right number now.
Okay.
But I was getting before the 12. I was getting right at the 0.8333.
Yeah, that's the end.
0.90 something.
Oh.
I don't know why it's. I'm actually getting the right answer now. But.
Okay. Okay. Everybody good? Sorry. Yes. Okay. All right. Let's move forward. Okay. So. Let's say we want to add in loan origination fees. Okay? So let's over here, loan origination fees. Okay? And let's say those are going to be 5%. Okay? And so I'll make that a nice, pretty 5%. Keep the decimals out a couple places. All right. So, let us talk about loan origination fees, what those are and how those work. Obtain a loan, whether it's a commercial loan or residential loan, normally they're going to charge you some type of loan origination fee. Sometimes they call it like discount points. Sometimes they'll refer to it as buying down the interest rate. Sometimes they'll refer to it as a lot of different things, but at the end of the day, it's loan origination fees. It's basically you're paying some sort of an upfront charge to the lender. And in essence, what's happening is that fee or that dollar amount is going to obviously increase your effective cost of borrowing. But this is money you pay up front. So the prepayment penalty was at the back end of the loan. This is all at the front end of the loan. All right? So let's just think about this mechanically here for a second. All right, so looking at this kind of like a timeline, and you know, we can do it over the full 360 months. And so in under ordinary circumstances, from the borrower point of view, what has happened? They're receiving a positive $100,000 here at time period zero. Yes? They are making negative payments of $877.57 for 360 months, and at the end of that 360 months, balance equals $0. Okay? Everybody kosher with that? Yes? No? Possibly could be. Okay. Now, if we add in loan origination fees of 5%, 5% of $100,000 is what? $5,000. So what is really happening, and this is the part to get your head around, you are really, as the borrower, giving the lender $5,000 of hard cash money at the time of closing, meaning, really, from the lender's point of view, how much money net are they really dispersing?
$95,000.
That is the most mission critical piece of information to make sure that you wrap your head around, because you've got to understand that logic before we go further with this, because if that doesn't make sense to you, everything kind of from this point forward will be a complete mess. Okay? The whole point from the lender's perspective is they're really in net only really dispersing 95 grand. Okay, does everybody understand that? Yes or no? With the 5% loan origination fee. Okay, now, here's what we're gonna do. We go in 12 payments per year, and we put in the original 100,000 as our loan amount. We put in the 10% as our interest rate. We put in our 30-year term. We solve for our monthly payment. We get our $877.57. We have to do all of those first normal steps. Okay? We can't shortcut this part of the process. So we put it in just as we ordinarily would. Okay? Now, what we do next is what matters. What we do next is we say, oh, we've got the 100,000, we have to subtract out the 5,000 loan origination fee, which is gonna equal to 95,000, yes? I'm just putting the steps to make sure you don't get lost in the procedure. After we do that, what we're gonna do is we're simply going to type in that as our new present value. So in other words, 95,000 is going to be our new present value. Does that make sense, everybody? Yes or no? We're not going to be changing our payment. We're not going to be changing our interest rate. We're not going to be changing our term. We're just going to be changing the present value or the loan amount to reflect that $5,000 of loan origination fees. Everybody kosher with that? Yes or no? Okay, now, this is the part that's easy. What are we gonna solve for?
Interest rate.
Okay, everybody get that? Yes? If you didn't get that, let me know. Now make sure if you're not getting that, clear your calculator out. Okay. So 10.62. So what is that telling us? That our effective cost of borrowing went up from the 10% to the 10.62, taking into account that loan origination fee of $5,000, okay? Everybody cool with that, conceptually, yes or no?
No.
Okay, now, here's the interesting piece. That's 10.62%, and what assumption is made there about payoff?
That there is no payoff.
In other words, there is no early payoff.
There is no early payoff.
That basically the payoff is going to be at the end of 360 months, yes?
Right.
So what if we were to pay off the loan early? What's going to happen to that number? It's going to go up. Because once again, you've got fewer months to amortize that cost over. Does that make sense? Okay, now add that to the double whammy of the prepayment penalty. What's going to happen? It's going to go up even more. Add that to the triple threat of all the loan servicing fees. It's going to go up even higher. You follow where I'm going with this? Okay. The bottom line is lenders are evil.
How do you... is it too complicated to, or at least conceptually, if you could explain how would you combine the effective cost of borrowing with the prepayment penalty?
We're about to do that.
Plus, oh,
okay. So right now, what we're going to do is we're going to kind of keep them separate, because I just want to show you the logic on kind of keeping them separate, and then we're going to combine them together. We're going to combine all three ultimately together. Okay. All right. So. One of the things that we are going to make the assumption of in this particular case is that the payoff is going to occur just like we did previously at, let's say, month 36. Or we can change it to month 360. It doesn't really matter because it will calculate it for us. Okay? So what we need to do is we can say, okay, can we just somehow adjust this little formula to incorporate all of it for us? What do you think? Yes, we can. Because all we have to do, think about this for a second. What number are we adjusting?
The present value.
The present value. So we look in here and we see the third item over is the present value, which is what?
C3.
So now, all we're going to have to do, this is where, once again, your beautiful brain can go to work. How do we adjust that? We're simply going to take that $100,000 and do what? Multiply it by the 5% and subtract it. Okay, to get the 95 grand. Okay, so let's just see if we can figure out how to do that. So if we were to take the C3, we could do it potentially by saying times 1 minus the 5%, and see if that does it. It shouldn't do it for us. You're saying, what did I just do? Okay, think about what I just did. Okay, I'm going to leave those numbers there for a second. So if I had $100,000 originally, which was the C3 reference, okay, and I were to multiply that by 1 minus the 5%, which is the cell B5, but that's 1 minus 0.05.
You're basically multiplying by the 95%.
Right, which is giving us
the
95,000. Does everybody see that? Just simplifies it a little bit. So, in essence, that's going to give us the 95,000. Cool, huh?
Very cool.
Okay, so, now, hold on. Okay, so we push that, we get 12.84. So, well, that's not the right answer. Yeah, it is, because it's combining both of them. Okay, now, you're saying, well, what if I just want to isolate just the loan origination fees? Simple. Boom. We get rid of that. Now, if we say, well, wait a second, that's still higher than this. Well, what is that? That's after 36 months. What about after 360 months? 10.62. Is that not super cool?
Yeah.
Can you not just wait and, you know, go home today and tell your significant other how cool that is? Okay? All right. Now. Okay, so let's go back up here for a second. Let's put back in this case, the 3% for our prepayment penalty. And then the prepayment, in this case, the payoff is 36 months. Okay, so that gets back to where both of those are being computed together, the 12.8496%. Okay? Does that make conceptual sense to everybody? Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, the next logical question, well, there's two next logical questions, but one of those next logical questions is, okay, how can I get this number on my calculator? Well, basically, you're going to, yeah, kind of do the same thing, but we're going to have to, you're going to think through the logic of what it is we're having to put in to get to that number. Does that make sense? Okay, so let's just see if we can figure it out. $877.57. All right. So once we've got all of that, now we can begin to start sort of substituting things as we have figured them out already. Okay. We have already figured out, and we can go through the steps to actually. We'll go ahead and just do that for the. So one input 36 shift amortize equal. All right, so this is going to give us our payoff amount of the $98,151.65. Okay, everybody good with that? We're going to multiply that by, and what we can do here to save ourselves a step, I'm just doing a little bit different, so pay attention. Instead of multiplying this by 0.03, multiply it by 1.03, that way it multiplies it by itself plus the 3%. That way we get the all-inclusive number that we need for the payoff. Does that make sense? So in so doing, okay, let me get this all input here real quick. Okay, we get that times 1.03, and that gives us 101,096,1920 rounded. Okay, all right. So we got this number, which is going to be the total payoff, correct? With the penalty assessed, yes?
Yeah.
Okay. This is where it gets really cool. Okay, so we take this number and we make it a negative number. And we input that as our future value. Okay? So we take the 101, so I'm running out of time here. I'm going to raise this so you guys can still see it. Over there. Okay? So we get the 101,096.2 plus minus future value as our future value. Okay? Now what we do, okay, thinking through the logic, what is our new term? What's our new term? Our term is no longer 30 years, it is 36 months. So right after that, put in 36 in. Okay. What else has changed? If we were to stop right there and just simply solve for the interest rate, we would get the original sort of cost of borrowing just for what? The prepayment penalty.
Right.
But what we have to do is one more step, which is to change the present value to $95,000 and then solve for the interest rate. And if we've done everything correctly, we should get to 12.84%. Okay? And do we?
Yes.
Okay. Super cool, huh?
This is wonderful.
All right. All right, now, we have one piece remaining, and we're almost out of time. That's okay. So the one piece remaining is to deal with ongoing sort of cost, if you will, within the loan, in terms of like monthly servicing fees or monthly administrative costs. Okay, you think we can do that in 3 minutes?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so let's say monthly servicing, oops, I didn't spell, servicing costs. All right, and this one I'm gonna do as a dollar amount, and I'm just gonna put in $100 a month. And I'm gonna make that a nice, pretty currency there with dollar sign and everything. Okay. Who's the A student that can tell me how we can do this in just literally under a minute? What, think about the only thing you're going to be adjusting. So what you're really saying here with monthly servicing costs is what's really happening here?
You're
adjusting your monthly payment.
Plus $100.
Plus $100. So we go over here. Once again, to our little effective cost of borrowing, it's getting more and more gargantuan, okay? And we go specifically to the payment piece of this. Right, so we should be able to just do -100, and let's see if that works for us. Yep. So all I did was, right here, the only change I made was, it said minus C7, which was our original payment, of A7757, and then I, because it's negative, make it a negative I4 to add in the $100, and in so doing, boom.
I want to be a banker.
Is that not awesome? Okay. All right. Right on schedule. Amazing. Okay. We'll see you guys back next week. Now make sure that you have read Chapter 3, a lot of the stuff that we have done today covers actually the first couple of chapters that we have assigned. So some of this should actually begin to look familiar, okay, as you're reading. So that's not a bad thing. But make sure you read Chapter 3, and then we'll have a little quiz at the end of that, and then we'll have other material. Yes, sir?
Is the quiz at the end?
Okay. Yes.
Okay.
And the quiz is the 1 through 10.
Yes. But if you take a look at that list, we've actually already covered several of those things.
I have them.
And we'll cover some of them again in a different way. Okay? But at least this gets you started. Yep.
So I was assuming that I had that first part on the calculator from the last thing that we did. But when I just changed some numbers, basically you have to do it all over again, right?
Yes. Okay, get out of here, go out, eat lunch. Just Professor Wurzer, if you're in his class, he wants you back on time at 12:30. The rest of you can go home and go do something else. This is not the cash on cash. This is just simply what is the overall return on the property if you went with the lender's valuation.
Oh, okay.
Yep. Sorry.
What is this video
going up? I'm going to probably upload it tonight or first thing tomorrow, one of the two. Or actually, probably do it right now in the 30 minutes between the class. Don't worry about those. I mean, within the next week or so, I will. There's really not much you're going to have to do.
Okay.
So, but just yeah. Just relax.
Okay. Good.
The GIS. Yeah. I don't have a problem with it.
Oh, okay.
next week.
Okay, thank
yeah.
you.
Yeah. Are you, do you have the next slide?
Oh, no, actually, no.
No. I gotta go stay there till 4:30.
Did that last semester?
No, no. You have the next slide?
All day.
Yeah,
you're starting on it.
You are.